Good afternoon, distinguished colleagues and guests. Please allow me to consider open the meeting of the Dissertation Council for the defense of Zolotarev Pavel Nikolaevich's thesis for the doctor degree of medical sciences on specialization 140203, public health and health care service, on the topic scientific rationale for multi-factor approach of laboratory service performance assessment in the Russian Federation constituted entity. According to the order of St. Petersburg State University from the 25th of November 2019, number 1159-8/1, me, Akulin Igor Mikhailovich, Doctor of Medical Sciences, Professor, Head of the Department of the Healthcare and Medical Law of St. Petersburg State University, was appointed the chairman of this dissertation council. And also allow me to introduce my fellow board members: Mironenko Olga Vasilievna, Doctor of Medical Sciences, Professor, Department of Health Organization and Medical Law of St. Petersburg State University; Mishkov Dmitry Olegovich, Doctor of Medical Sciences, Head of the Laboratory of the Management of Public Health, Head of the Research and Information Coordination Sector; Linden Bratton Alexey Leonidovich, Head of the Department of Economic Research in Healthcare of National Institute of Public Health, named after Simashka; Gaidarov Maimedovich, Head of the Department of the Public Health and Healthcare Service of the Irkutsk State University; Kasalapov Vladimir Petrovich, Doctor of Medical Sciences, Professor. He is online via Skype. We can see him. Glad to see you. Head of the Department of Public Health and Healthcare of the Hygiene of the Institute of Continuing Professional Education of the Voronezh State Medical Institute, named after Burdenko Bilalov; Fyodor Salimovich, Head of the Scientific and Educational Department of Public Association, Central Asian Association of Medical Laboratory Diagnostics and Examinations. According to the law, to the federal law from the 23rd of August 1996, number 127, Federal Law on Science and the State Scientific and Technical Policy, St. Petersburg State University has the right to independently award academic degrees. The corresponding order on the procedure for awarding academic degrees at St. Petersburg State University, on the basis of which we conduct our meeting, was issued on the 1st of September 2016, number 68/21/1, hereinafter the order. In accordance with this order, the meeting of the Dissertation Council is considered eligible if at least two-thirds of the approved membership of the Dissertation Council takes part in its work, but not less than four persons. There are six members of the Council, all of them are present, including one who is in the remote interactive mode. The agenda: the chairman's summary report on the main content of the documents submitted by the candidate and their compliance with the established requirements; brief report of the candidate for the degree; questions to the candidate strictly according to his report, no more than 2 minutes for one question; responses of the candidate; the speeches of all the members of the thesis council by turns, with reviews, with a statement of their positions, with questions and suggestions to the candidate, no more than 10 minutes for the speaker; the speech of the chairman with his review; the answers of the candidate for the degree to the questions and remarks of the members of the dissertation council, no more than 15 minutes; open discussion; speeches at the request of those present at the defense of the thesis. At the same time, all interested persons are requested to register in the registration sheet and, before submitting their speech, fully introduce themselves. Final answers of the applicant to the questions asked, no more than 5 minutes. The speech of the scientific supervisor, no more than 3 minutes. A 5 minute break before an open vote in order to make a conclusion on the issue of awarding or not awarding the academic degree of St. Petersburg State University to the candidate. For the time of the discussion, the broadcast is turned off. An open individual voting. counting of votes by the chairman of the dissertational council with entering the results in the minutes of the meeting. Decision on awarding or not awarding the academic degree of St. Petersburg State University, the final word of the applicant, no more than 2 minutes. Dear board members, do you have any questions or remarks or suggestions? If not, before switching to the realization of the meeting's rules of the procedure, I remind you to switch off your mobile phones. Thank you for your attention. I also inform you that an audio and video recording of our meeting is being conducted, as well as a live broadcast on the website of St. Petersburg State University. Simultaneous interpretation of speeches from Russian into English or from English into Russian is also provided. Let me start the procedure of the meeting. Chairman summary report. The dissertation of Zolotarev Pavel Nikolaevich for the doctorate degree of medical sciences on specialty 140203, public health and healthcare service, on the topic scientific rationale for multi-factor approach of laboratory service performance assessment in the Russian Federation constituted entity, was accepted for the defense by the scientific secretary from the 25th of November 2019, number 11597/1. The thesis council was approved on the 25th of November 2019, number 11598/1, and I have already introduced it to you. The candidate submitted the following documents to the scientific secretary: a list of publications, the diploma of the candidate of sciences, the conclusion from the organization, National Scientific Institute named after Semashka. The thesis is done in Russian and English, both in paper-based version as in manuscript, and in the electronic form. The thesis is designed in accordance with the requirements of National State Standard R70. It should be noted that all listed documents comply with paragraph 12 of section 3, presentation and defense of dissertations. Procedure for awarding academic degrees at St. Petersburg State University. Appendix number 1 to the order. And now, Pavel Nikolaevich, your brief report, 20 minutes. Distinguished board members and the long-term strategy of health service development in the Russian Federation states that the highest possible level of the national health care is only achievable with full-fledged health service system binding together all the medical services and organizations. The laboratory service should be one of the backbone elements. However, the clinical laboratory service still has significant issues, including analysis of the medical test dynamics with respect to available laboratory equipment, medical staffing level, further work towards maximal availability of the laboratory technologies, customer satisfaction evaluation, imperfection of the laboratory medicine, conceptual question, and so on. Another current problem is the lack of unified methodological approaches for the performance of a comprehensive analysis of the regional and federal laboratory services. The aim of the research, the modernization of the technological approaches for laboratory service performance assessment in the Russian Federation constituent entity, the tasks of the research. First, to examine the laboratory service in the Russian Federation to identify its development issues. Number two, to propose and to justify the additions to the laboratory medicine conceptual questions. Three, to analyze the existing indicators of the laboratory service work in the Russian Federation constituent entity and to identify the most significant of them for further development of a multi-factor assessment approach. Number four, to develop a comprehensive laboratory service performance assessment and a mathematical model for its integrated analysis. Number five, to examine the production capacities needed for the developed comprehensive assessment. Number six, to analyze the dynamics of the staff indicators within the framework of the developed multi-factor approach. Seven, to identify the regional trends in the laboratory service consumers' opinions after improving the methodological approaches. Number 8, to suggest the improvements of the medical laboratory services delivery, scientific novelty, the comprehensive laboratory service performance assessment for the Russian Federation constituent entity has been developed. It is based on the production capacities, human resources, data, and consumer opinion. The most significant indicators of the Russian Federation constituent entity laboratory service performance were highlighted. At the same time, we got new data on the dynamics of the laboratory researchers, equipment status, and its rational use, as well as the laboratory staff data. Different expertise level of laboratory staff has been established. The physicians' demand for the medical laboratory services has been recognized. The level of the laboratory services customer satisfaction in the Russian Federation constituent entity has been evaluated. The concept of a medical laboratory service has been newly proposed and justified. The mathematical model for the Russian Federation constituent entity laboratory service performance assessment has been developed for the first time. The ways to improve the medical laboratory service delivery have been proposed and justified. Practical significance of the research. The developed comprehensive assessment of the Russian Federation constituent entity laboratory service performance helps to highlight the problem areas with respect to the diversity of regional healthcare features and suggest the ways to improve the medical laboratory service delivery, specifically to calculate the optimal load on the laboratory equipment considering the dynamics of the laboratory tests, to assess the demand for the medical laboratory staff, and based on this information to propose the ways to improve the training program for different laboratory staff, to increase accessibility and to meet the needs for medical laboratory services among physicians and patients. Based on the developed laboratory software, it is possible to get an objective multi-factor analysis of the laboratory service state and suggest its improvements. The laboratory software for administrators will be helpful for staff work optimization when they deal with attending physicians' referrals or for the laboratory tests. This program could be used as a complementary module for the medical laboratory software. Subject of the research, the laboratory service of the Russian Federation's constituent entity, scope of the research, organization of the laboratory service work of in the Russian Federation constituent entity on the example of the Samara region, research-based laboratory service of the public and private healthcare facilities in the Samara region, research geography, the Samara region. Research methods and approaches are provided on this slide. They include general scientific methods in the form of a system analysis and a structural and functional approach, and private specific and as mathematical and statistical methods. It has been established that from production capacities point of view, a number of foreign countries such as the USA, Japan, France, the laboratory service work with the priority of the laboratory test to be done on site and subsequent optimization of the laboratory test volume was established. In the Russian Federation, one of the priorities of the production capacities development is still the service centralization, which has already been successfully implemented in the cities like Moscow, Omsk, Novosibirsk, and Tumen. The Samara region currently has no single policy of the service centralization, while the volume of the laboratory researchers has constantly been growing over the years. Analysis of the staff situation showed that in many countries, a higher education specialist is a medical pathologist whose functions include advising the treating doctors and patients. It influences the number of studies performed by the higher education specialists. IT development is another important priority for laboratory service development, both in Russia and the Samara region in particular. However, currently we have no more than 30 types of the information systems because there is no unified information policy. In Russia, we use a number of ISO standards, most of which are identical to the world standards. The occupational standards for the laboratory medicine specialists are also being actively developed. Herein with, it is important to note that the Samara region has no local regulatory documents managing the laboratory service work. In the view of the trends above, further development and improvement of the laboratory service work, it is impossible without unified laboratory service performance assessment approach. As of today, we don't have such a system both in Russia and the other in the other countries. Before talking about the implementation of this priority area, it is important to set up a definition of a previously absent concept, a medical laboratory service. It is necessary for a single interpretation of the studied indicators of the obtained results. The new concept of a medical laboratory service is based on the definitions of a medical service, a medical intervention, and diagnostics described in the Federal Law number 323 and amended by the concepts of pre-analytical and post-analytical stages of the laboratory process. All this data help to set up a definition. A medical laboratory service, it is a consequence of the actions to be done by a healthcare professional in order to recognize the medical problem or to differentiate normal condition from the pathological one. These actions are realized via laboratory tests, have an independent completed value from the administration and until the result of the study. This is the first time the concept got this wording. There was nothing similar, both in the domestic and foreign literature ever before. Based on the analysis of the domestic and foreign scientific publications, legal acts, and statistical reporting forms, we have studied different indicators of the laboratory service work that could potentially be used for its assessment. We have analyzed both primary indicators and universal ones, for example, applicable for various constituent entities of the Russian Federation, as well as various areas of the laboratory service work. The studied indicators were summarized into the following directions: production capacities, 18 indicators, staff indicators, 21 indicators, consumers' opinion, 24 indicators. Based on the expert assessments method, we made a sample of 63 indicators to use them for the Russian Federation Constituent Entity Laboratory Service performance assessment. The following indicators were found to be statistically significant, and altogether we have had 24 indicators. They became the basis for a mathematical model of an integral assessment of the Russian Federation Constituent Entity Laboratory Service, and their detailed analysis allowed us to demonstrate the practical significance of the developed model on the example of the Samara region. At the next step of the research, we developed four-level system of comprehensive assessment. The fourth level of the system is the level of the final integral indicator. The third level is the level of the directions describing the laboratory service activity on macro level. A. Production capacities. B. Staff indicators. C. Consumer's opinion. As the second level is the level of the factors. The first level is the level of the indicators describing different aspects of the laboratory service activity in a particular Russian Federation constituent entity in order to identify the initial variables of the first level and make them applicable for the subsequent construction of the integral assessments. At the second level, each initial variable was converted into a private selection criterion with the property of preference ranking using forward and backward asymmetric transformation. Each indicator was brought to a single 100-point scale. The factors were transformed into the directions considering the weight coefficients corresponding to each factor. The weight coefficients for each of the factors were either determined by the expert community of the Russian Federation constituent entity or considered to be equal to one. It has been proposed to calculate the final integral indicator as a simple sum of the directions estimates. Thus, the maximum value of the final integral indicator could reach 300. While working on the comprehensive assessment system, we realized the necessity for a software which could help to collect and consolidate relevant information and to calculate some essential for assessment. In order to solve this problem, the thesis author developed a software for regional laboratory service evaluation with a certificate of software registration. It has also been used for preparation of the methodological guidelines approved by the Ministry of Health of the Samara region. The software has three levels developed depending on the needs of the specialist working in it. And on the example of Samara region three directions were developed. And analysis of the production capacities showed that positive quantitative dynamics of the microbiological and immunological tests were a result of the growing number of sophisticated microbiological equipment, herein with decreasing number of simple immunological equipment did not affect the above mentioned positive dynamics. It has been established that decreased quantity of simple equipment did not result in a decreasing number of cytological and biochemical examinations. An increasing number of hematological and coagulologic equipment did not result in a positive trend towards the number of the relevant studies performed, meaning the rationality and significance of purchasing the new hematological and coagulologic equipment was overstated. The analysis of the human resources over the years showed positive dynamics in the number of the employees, the staffing rates, and the ratio of the higher education laboratory specialists per population. Meanwhile, there is a negative trend in the number of the occupied staffing grades and staffing level among the paramedical specialists, as well as the ratio of higher education paramedical laboratory specialists. This demonstrates difficult situation with paramedical laboratory staff. This research showed that the number of the tests per higher education specialists has been decreasing over the years, both due to increasing number of the employees and redistribution of the labor functions between medical and paramedical staff. This is a positive trend throughout all the Russian Federation, but still it did not reach the global tasks, meaning the fact that there is a need for further revision of the labor functions and employees' competencies. A secondary employment rate both for higher and secondary education employees has negative trend and trends to 1 and 5 respectively, providing that the Samara Region Laboratory Service tries to follow the requirements of the labor legislation where one employee cannot occupy more than 1.5 FTEs full-time equivalent. Thus, the Samara region data should become a basis for development of the extensive measures for staff policy optimization by increasing the number of the paramedical professionals, reviewing the employees' labor functions, education optimization via adaptation of the undergraduate and postgraduate programs. Analysis of the laboratory service consumers' opinion showed low accessibility of the laboratory services as well as high demand for the external laboratories among the doctors working in the dispensaries, living in the urban districts, and doctors from the private medical institutions. It also has been determined that urban doctors, 91%, and doctors from the public medical institutions, 90%, have the maximum demand for information on the modern laboratory diagnostic capabilities. These problem areas require a strategy focused on improving the professional competence of the laboratory professionals and improving the training process for those people who are going to work in the laboratory service. and the analysis of the laboratory results, accessibility from a technological point of view showed that 58% of the respondents receiving results at the front desk and 70% of the respondents receiving them by phone or fax are not satisfied with the actual way of getting the results. Most of them are ready to switch to emailing or using a personal account on the internet. These specific results demonstrate a high demand for service IT development. Customer satisfaction evaluation showed that the patient who did not get the necessary volume of the laboratory tests tends to be more rigorous in the evaluation of the other service indicators. We have also found that patients under 18 years old are more demanding to the quality of the service than adults. They reported lower satisfaction with the receptionist's work, 74%, and the level of the comfort in the medical office, 76%. Male respondents evaluated comfort level of the medical office and easiness to locate it a little lower than women, 78% and 85% respectively. We summarized the problem areas of the laboratory service, and we have found that in the Samara region, the developed multi-factor approach for the laboratory service performance assessment and confirmed during the research approbation. They include irrationality of purchasing and the subsequent use of sophisticated laboratory equipment, negative dynamics of the paramedical staff situation, imbalance of the labor functions and volumes of the laboratory researchers done between the employees of various specialties, high doctors' demand for the services of the external laboratories and relevant information, low availability of the laboratory researchers and the technological ways of getting the results by the doctors, low satisfaction with the spectrum of laboratory service in the certain groups of patients. In order to solve the identified problems, we developed the ways to improve the medical laboratory services delivery focused on better availability of the services for various categories of population, improving the professional competence of medical and non-medical laboratory professionals, as well as creating a single medical and laboratory information system for the service needs. In order to improve the availability of the laboratory services for various categories of population, we developed and proposed a concept of extending and retail network of the biomaterial sampling stations in the Samara region, a franchise project for the federal laboratory networks, and a laboratory mobile for the needs of the rural regions. There are three ways of improving the laboratory medicine expertise level of medical and non-medical staff: laboratory trainings for the medical specialists, education and preparation for the laboratory staff, training for non-medical staff to work in the laboratory service field, creation of a three-level unified medical and laboratory information system for the laboratory service needs. This software has been registered with the certificate of registration, laboratory software for a clinical diagnostic laboratory administrator. I suggest not to stop too long at the conclusions and practical recommendations as they are described in details in the handouts. Thank you for your attention. I have finished. Pavel Nikolaevich, thank you very much. We follow our agenda. It is wonderful. And now, according to the agenda, the announcement of external reviews. There are no external reviews, and that's why now this reviews of the board members, and I offer the candidate to answer the reviews in turns. Mironenko Olga Vasilievna, please, the floor is yours. Distinguished Igor Mikhailovich, distinguished board members have studied the thesis materials of Zolotarev Pavel Nikolaevich placed at the website of St. Petersburg State University as the board members. I prepared my review. I'm a professor of the Department of Federal State Budget Institution of the Higher Education, St. Petersburg State University. On the topic of the thesis is scientific rationale for multi-factor approach of laboratory service performance assessment in the Russian Federation constituent entity. Submitted for the degree of the Doctor of Medical Sciences specialization, 14.03 public health and healthcare service. The actuality is without doubt because at the modern stage of the development of the medicine, the level 5B is very crucial for the implementations of new methods of diagnostics of diseases, which is necessary for to evaluate the activity of laboratory service. And the main tasks of the research are aimed at the creation of multi-factor approach for the organization of the work of laboratory service, complex assessment of its activity, which is very actual and timely. Scientific novelty of the research is in methodology, and for complex evaluation of the laboratory service state in the region, which includes indicators which characterize production capacities, staffing, and so on. For the first time, the author conducted complex analysis of the indicators of the laboratory service in Samara region. He obtained the data about the dynamics of the implementation of laboratory studies, equipment of the laboratories and its condition, rational use of these equipment and staff service. The author analyzed the availability and necessity of such laboratories at clinical level, and also medical and social monitoring of the satisfaction in the region with the medical laboratory service was conducted, and some scientifically justified indicators. The author recommends to use them as the criteria for complex assessment of the laboratory service state. For the first time, on the basis of the regulatory documentation and analysis of literary data, the author defines what the term medical laboratory service is. And the ways of the increase of the quality of medical service are offered. They are the following: the organization of the availability of medical laboratory services for the patients in the cities and rural areas via the development of retail chain of biomaterial receiving points in Samara region, the implementation of the concept of franchising presence of federal laboratories with the development of the concept of laboratory mobile for the needs of rural people, and non-medical specialists should be educated how to work in the laboratories. Practical significance of the research. Pavel Nikolaevich developed the methodology of the evaluation of the laboratory service in the region. It allows to evaluate factual staff of medical laboratories, offer the ways of improvement specialist training of different level of education for laboratory medicine and to understand the satisfaction of patients, taking into account the diversity of the regional peculiarities of the healthcare structure, to understand problematic zones of the activity of regional laboratory service and offer the ways of quality increase of medical laboratory service. The author developed the computer software which allows to, on the basis of main indicators of the activity of laboratory service, to evaluate its current states and also offer recommendations on improvements the service activity, certificate of state registration of a computer program from the 4th of July 2017. Also, there is a computer program of the Administrator of Clinical and Laboratory Diagnostics, the certificate of the state registration of a computer program. The reliability, novelty, and the extent of the justification of scientific provisions, conclusions and recommendations formulated in the thesis. The work is based on the regulatory basis, which includes the full hierarchy of legislative documents and allows to explain and prove and justify the use of scientific results in practical application. The main scientific provisions in the thesis are explained with the help of complex analysis of the indicators of the activity of laboratory service received from official statistical forms, and the literary sources include 352 sources. 255 sources are in Russian and 97 are in foreign languages. The analysis is conducted on the diverse basis of the data with the use of objective modern statistical indicators and survey of the patients, doctors, including laboratory service and heads in healthcare service, different level. The candidate submitted 27 articles, including one article in Scopus, and in 15 scientific articles in journals recommended by High Attestation Committee. And this system of indicators is reasoned and can be used in every constituent entity of the Russian Federations. The novelty of the research and the results are based on the official statistical indicators of the activity of laboratories of the Russian Federation constituent entities. And for the analysis of the data, our candidate applied a wide spectrum of statistical methods of data processing. They include correlation, regression, and other types of analysis. The thesis is very clear, and it is very well designed, and it is written on 299 pages, but there are some questions for our candidate. One small remark, for example, in the second paragraph of the third chapter, the author shows eight pictures. They are represented in color, but they should be represented in black and white because the reading of the thesis can impede the interpretation of the material. It would be advisable to make them in black and white. And there are also some questions, three questions I would like to ask our candidate, Pavel Nikolaevich. Question one, which general complexes were used in the dissertation, which helped you to make the conclusions, which indicators were studied in order to evaluate the character of the activity of specialists of clinical laboratory diagnostics, and please outline the methods of statistical data processing which were used for the solution of each specific problems. Please, problems and specific methods of statistical processing, but these questions and remarks are of discussive character. They don't spoil the overall impression from the thesis. And the conclusion about the compliance of the thesis with the criteria stated by the order procedure on awarding degrees at St. Petersburg State University, and it is the following. The thesis of Zolotarev Pavel Nikolaevich on the topic scientific rationale for multi-factor approach of laboratory service performance assessment in the Russian Federation constituent entity conforms with the requirements stated by the order from the 1st of September 2016, number 68/21/1, procedure on awarding degrees at St. Petersburg State University, and our candidate deserves the doctoral degree in medical sciences, specialization 140203, public health and healthcare service. Point 11 of the order was not violated by our candidate. Павел Николаевич, your answers to the questions and distinguished Olga Vasilievna, please allow me to answer your three questions. The first question about general complexes. There were three general complexes. The number of clinicians in Samara. And number three, the number of patients who go to laboratories, all Samara residents. And the first one, population of all specialists with high education, employees of the Samara region. And the nature of the laboratory specialist's work was assessed with respect to the following indicators. Number of FTEs and employees with higher and secondary education. Number of the laboratory specialists per 10,000 people of population, correlation between high and secondary education laboratory service specialists, number of the laboratory tests per employee, staffing level, secondary employment rate for higher and secondary education specialists, proficiency, duty performance, and passive proficiency in a number of types of the laboratory tests. The following mathematical and statistical methods were used to solve the problem of this thesis research: time series analysis, correlation analysis, regression analysis, and priori ranking and analysis. We considered eight problems, and we used mathematical and statistical methods for the expert evaluation. We used Kendall coefficients of concordance. We used Pearson criterion to determine the significance of Kendall coefficients of concordance. The mathematical model and the final integral indicator are based on asymmetric transformation of the indicators into the private criteria for the first level. We used time series analysis with linear regression models to study the quantitative dynamics of the types of the laboratory studies and numerical composition of the laboratory equipment. Assessment of the relationship between the number of laboratory tests done and the number of the laboratory equipment is based on the correlation analysis. Number six, staffing trends were studied by the time series analysis. Every indicator has been assigned to the most accurate approximating function. The reliability of the approximation was characterized by the coefficient of determination, R2, and task 7. The results of the consumer assessment were presented in the contingency tables. Therefore, we use the analysis of the contingency tables with HE criterion, HE square criterion. Distinguished Igor Mikhailovich, two more questions according to your report. Pavel Nikolaevich, please explain to me, you studied the state of laboratory service of Samara region, and approximately please give the characteristics of the private sector of the laboratory service, percentage rate. And the second question is connected with the situation in Samara region on the implementation of the management of quality standards. And judging from your report, this process can't be called efficient in comparison to the Russian Federation, for example. Distinguished Olga Vasilievna, if we speak about laboratory service, in this case we try to maximally cover not only public sector, we also wanted to focus on commercial sector. It is very difficult to structure it. And the most, if we speak about commercial sector, there are a lot of non-federal organizations when laboratory research is done out of Samara region, and how can we take into account this research in Samara, Samara platform or out of Samara, and up to 20-30% of laboratory service market, laboratory research market in Samara region, we can attribute to commercial medicine. And answering the question about the standardization within the frames of the quality standards in Samara region, after studying, auditing documents, we understood that this direction is actively developing, but it requires organization and administrative solutions in order to achieve the level of other regions. I hope that this work will be conducted in successfully conducted in the near future. I am satisfied with the answers of our candidate. And one more question. Answering the first question concerning private sector, am I right that such huge private chain laboratories such as Helix or City Lab, your medical institute, do your Samara institutions use their services? Are these external platforms for providing these services, or there are chain laboratories in Samara which are which centralize this service in Samara region? There are laboratories of both federal level which provide services out of Samara, and laboratories which conduct services in Samara, and plus regional chain laboratories. And the point of departure is the place of the research, laboratory research. The demand is higher than the population. Thank you very much. Distinguished colleagues, are there any other questions according to the report? No questions. And please, please introduce yourself, use the mic, and we will fix your question.
Включите, пожалуйста, микрофончик на кнопочку, пожалуйста.
Please switch on the microphone. Head of the Department of the Organization of the Healthcare in the Military Academy, Rusev, Professor Rusev. I have a question. You know the order from the Ministry of Healthcare from the October 2017. It offers the list of medical services which are available today, and in accordance with such services, special price policy is created. More than 27 types of medical services. 12 of them include diagnostic research, laboratory research. You offer the definition of medical laboratory service as know-how as offered by you for the first time. But I want to say for the near future, for example, radiologists, surgeons can act in such a way. What is the difference between medical service of which is defined in this order and medical laboratory service which you offer? The matter is, when we speak about medical service, initially we did not plan to consider such a task for our dissertation research, but the results are contradictory for interpretation. It is difficult to elaborate the unit for the evaluation of our multi-factor component. If we speak about medical service of non-laboratory profile, it is much broader. And when we faced with the fact that medical services, it is the implementation of the research, it is another thing where we take into account only the analytical stage of laboratory research. In our case, when we define medical laboratory service, we took into account pre-analytical stage, analytical stage, and post-analytical stage, because with the help of modern opportunities of laboratory diagnostics, such processes are separated. Pre-analytical stage can be done in Samara region. Analytical stage can be done in another constituent entity of the Russian Federation. And post-analytical results can be done in other region. That's why we introduced a new term, medical laboratory service, which is the subject of our second part of our dissertation research. No voice in the microphone.
Микрофончику, пожалуйста, подойдите.
No voice in the microphone.
Подойдите, пожалуйста, к микрофону. Да.
I would like to remind you that we ask questions strictly according to the report. Strictly according to the report. One more question. It is a medical laboratory service attributed to the laboratory administrator or to a treating doctor. In this case, it is significant for the doctor of laboratory diagnostics, and also it is connected with the treating doctors, diagnostic doctors, beyond the frames of the clinical laboratory diagnostics. Thank you. Are there any other questions? Distinguished colleagues, I would like to use the opportunity to ask questions strictly according to the report, and questions connected with the definition of medical service, and I fully agree. It is very important for any service. A pre-analytical stage, which starts with from the moment of the prescription. But in practice, the situation is the following: when a patient is taken into hospital, and the patient receives the list of diagnostic researches in accordance with the standards which are necessary to be fulfilled by him before being taken into hospital. Can it be the start of the service of providing this service? The patient must go to the point and receive all the list of services. Where is the point of the departure for the beginning of the providing of this medical service? Where is the beginning of the service? From the moment of the prescription of the doctor, or the requirements for the fulfillment of the research before being taken into hospital. Alexander Leonidovich, I would like to comment upon that. When we speak about the necessity of this service, it can be it can come from the doctor or from the patient. It is the necessity or the availability of this service when the patient comes to the medical cabinet, procedure cabinet, and then he comes to the registrar's office where he receives the results. It is the medical laboratory service. Strictly according to the report, you, speaking about the methods of the research, named the method of the analysis of prior ranging, the practice shows when we use this approach for a priori ranging, sometimes there are profitable indicators, controllable indicators, which allow to calculate integral indicator and to receive specific advantages. Can it lead to the policy, certain policies, such indicators are more significant, thus I will use such these indicators. Without doubt, any statistical method has specific strong and weak points of this application. We considered other methods, and we saw the fluctuations of our indicators. They could lead to different interpretations and dubious character. Thank you very much. Are there any questions according to the report? The next report, Dmitry Olegovich Mishkov. The report is prepared. if you allow me, less formal and more emotional arrange of provisions, and I will read them out. First of all, I would like to say about overall impression from this work. The criteria of the good work is the following, that there are reasons for further research. It is a completed work, completed scientific work, and all in all, it is a criteria of a successful work. On the one hand, this work gives us the opportunity to consider the problem, to understand the mechanisms which are assessed and represented by the author, and see the connection of these mechanisms with other areas of healthcare system and the organization of healthcare system. And the discussion concerning the definition of what laboratory service is, it covers principal questions. The frames of regulatory documents should be taken into account. They should be connected with reality. As for the actuality of the topic, it's not a secret. Today there is another scientific technical revolution. The changes of medical technologies, the changes of diagnostic procedures, diagnostic technologies, it requires the necessity of reconsidering of the situation with laboratory diagnostics and how the organization of laboratory diagnostics should be changed. And the work is actual. And some words about the work, about the reliability of this work, the volume of the information. And three complexes. Factual material is very complex, 350 reference. The author mastered and recycled, studied a huge volume of the material which was given by his predecessors. The analysis of the previous works allowed to write a qualitative work. It solved staffing questions, the questions with the equipment, the questions of asymmetry, disbalance in laboratory diagnostics, to increase those necessary, the availability of those necessary laboratory procedures which are necessary for the patients. This work is multifaceted. Whether this work is methodological or scientific and practical. And as for the positive features, it unifies all these three levels. On the one hand, methodology. And positive trends and new approaches for the methods of evaluation and preparation of the variant of the solution. methodological work on the basis of the methodology which are applied for the assessment of the situation with laboratory diagnostics in the region and one more important site of the this work is applicable not only in the sphere of laboratory diagnostics. That methodology and methods, the ways of analysis which are represented by the candidate, they can be applied in other spheres of healthcare and used to increase the medical help. If on the whole we can speak about the work, it is a completed scientific qualified work which is devoted to the healthcare and it conforms with the requirements of a specialty passport. And the material which was analyzed and the results which were obtained in the course of the research, they are very reliable. Methodological and scientific and practical approach, it adds the work to people. The work is complex and it creates the requirements for the all the prerequisites to understand everything, and it testifies that the topics which are analyzed, they are very actual and interesting for all those who are present. And judging from all mentioned above, I am sure that the work of Zolotarev Pavel Nikolaevich, scientific rationale for multi-factor approach of laboratory service performance assessment in the Russian Federation constituted entity, is reliable and has scientific and practical value. Specialization 14.0203, public health and healthcare service. And the conclusion, the thesis conforms with the criteria, procedure on awarding degrees. Of our candidate conforms with the requirements for the theses stated by the order from the 1st of September 2016, number 6821/1, procedure on awarding academic degrees at St. Petersburg State University, and the candidate Zolotarev Pavel Nikolaevich deserves the degree of the Doctor of Medical Sciences, specialization 14.0203, point 11, was not violated by the candidate. And after this official part, I would like to ask the question. It reflects my own interest. And as for laboratory diagnostics in Samara region, this form changed with the time, and there is a methodological and methodical question, how can and was it possible to eliminate the differences concerning the form, and how did you take into account the inhomogeneous character of the data you obtain? And the statistical data distinguished Dmitry Olegovich. In our work, we used 30 statistical forms in Samara region and the work of diagnostic laboratories. There were changes of the form, and our main task was to follow the whole complex, the integrity of statistical research. We took only those figures which can be and with the change of forms, some figures were not taken into account within the years, and statistically we lost this trend. We used the analysis of time ranges for the statistics, and linear regression indicators were used. Alexander Leonidovich, I give the floor to you. Let me focus on the main moments connected with the analysis of the thesis research and the conformity with the requirements for the doctoral theses. A few words about the topicality. I would like to underline that these keywords that are repeated complex assessments, systematic evaluation, today they are very actual. The trends and we go to another direction. We start to use in any medical sphere some narrow approaches. We forget that the organism, it is a whole system, connected system, and we come to symptomatic treatment in this work. Private question concerning diagnostic research. It is considered from different sides, from the position of the doctors which require the results, from the position of the research. They allow to create the background for a systematic approach. And on the basis of the first Moscow Medical Institute, the laboratory days of Russia, Menshikov, and one of the first who started to conduct and organize specific section connected with economic aspect of laboratory medicine. Over the last years, the works of distinguished Belalov, and a lot of attention is paid to the resources, information, and we speak the improvement of diagnostics, the improvement of the results of treatment, social factor, detailed factor, satisfaction. The term, general term, generalized term, satisfaction. For more rational use of the available resources, it is necessary for us to raise financing level, but if we don't speak about the rational mechanisms of the use of the finances, we won't reach any success. Those practical doctors who make a prescription, and finally, one of the main subjects of the system of healthcare service, it is a patient. Patient is a core in this system. It speaks about the fact that this research meets all the requirements concerning the novelty of the research, its significance, and this tested complex analysis allowed to use this model. And one more aspect, the work is very significant for the management, because this information is the basis for the managerial decisions. And I imagine the map with sensors the necessity of the search of the proper managerial decision and the new campaign, another campaign when money is offered. Qualification, it is the most important factor. We speak about the lack of the staff. We need not only to eliminate the lack of staff, we should eliminate the lack of qualified staff. And a significant approach, the calculation of integral indicators. Artificially created indicators, and we organizers very well understand some medical, demographic, and so on. We understand that politically it is very important task, and we have to understand what is behind the solution of these tasks, the essence of these indicators. That's why it is very important that these indicators lead to the solution of this approach complex assessment, all the components which are considered. The activity of all laboratory service, and it means the management and so on. I can say that in this work there is a requirement which is meant the implementation into practice. Pedagogic process. And recommendation, the preparation of some textbook. We should raise the qualification of medical staff, managerial staff. And it should become the subject for the use in the educational activity, and on the whole, it allows me to give the positive conclusion from this work, and I can't but focus on the remarks. And I think that when the work has the questions, I like the work, which makes us think, discuss anything. Formally, I have got three remarks. One of them is of technical character. The involvement of the author, literature review, everything is fine, but the compliance of the rubrics is improper, and the first one goes to the historical insights, technical remark, one more technical remark. In my opinion, it is very important for this work. In conclusion, it contains repetitions of the results of the research, and these materials it is necessary to conduct complex assessment of not only regional hierarchical level of the management. It is necessary to think about all the aspects. And in the last section about the further prospects of the research, of course it does not spoil the impression from the content of the work. And the last remark, which is rather discursive, the author, the whole system satisfaction a list with indexes the satisfaction of patients, and V29 the satisfaction from the quality of laboratory research. Can the patient evaluate the research, the quality of organization, the conditions? He can do it. Why I have the question. The next chapter, where Pavel Nikolaevich conducts a detailed study. The patient can't evaluate the technologies. He is satisfied. The patient can't assess how the analysis was done. The satisfaction with the quality of the organization of the activity in the laboratory. To know, use modern equipment, and so on. On the whole, I want to draw a conclusion. This work answers all the requirements which are stated by the order, procedure on awarding scientific degrees at St. Petersburg State University, and Pavel Nikolaevich deserves the degree of the Doctor of Medical Sciences on our specialization. Pavel Nikolaevich. Alexander Leonidovich, thank you for the remarks. I will take them into account, and it will help. They will help to visualize the material. And as for the quality of the research, it is not the competence of the patient. But when we speak about the chosen indicators and expert community did not consider the inclusion it into the assessment, and it allows us to create a unique problem without dubious indicators. Thank you very much, Pavel Nikolaevich. And now I would like to give the floor to Gaidar Mamedovich. No voice in the microphone. No voice in the microphone. Distinguished colleagues, I prepared my review very attentively. My review is placed on the website of St. Petersburg State University. I think that our candidate and consultant chose a proper topic of the dissertation. Timely, useful, practical, necessary for our today's healthcare service. It is connected with federal national project of the healthcare system, where is one of the main directions which is called territorial planning and regioning. And our candidate, under the guidance of his consultant, the state can ask him to buy everything he has done. These are huge territories. What does territory planning involve? We take a federal constituted entity, staff, wards, laboratory, centralized laboratory service. You remember when 10 years ago, I'm not only the head of the department today, but I am a chief doctor of medical, of university clinics, of medical university. Several years ago, I was the minister of healthcare in Irkutsk region. And what prevented me from successful work? Hematological analysis, bacteriological analysis were purchased in every municipal body. And today we see that our candidate offered methodology, structural shift of the whole system. He analyzed, gave the assessment, and gave the opportunity to study the necessity. For example, bulbs. In unavailable laboratory service, and there are people, there is a polyclinics, and it is the main it will allow not only to centralize but only to economize huge resources and to send the analysis to those locomotives which will deal with that. It is the first, the most important and useful for us today. I liked his statistical methods of the research. These are the modern methods. He showed that today we can analyze with the help of new methods which we use very seldom. Such statistical methods which of range Spearman methods of range correlations, the calculation of Hakkonen's coefficient of Kindle, methods of Manu-Whitney for dependent and independent selections. These methods give us the opportunity to show us all the conclusions and suggestions on the basis of the results. I think that what happened in Samara region, we lack additional information. What happened with basic institutions which our candidate named Samara Oncology Center, Regional Hospital, what happened with laboratory service? And I have some questions before I give the conclusion. The first one, did you conduct comparative characteristics before and after? Did you study initial stage of the laboratory service which was in such negative variant with different challenges which exist in many subjects? And are there any indicators which will give us pleasure? What happened to Samara Hospital and oncological center monitoring we implemented has radically changed? The next question, Samara region, whether there is a necessity in coordinating organizational structures on the level of regional Miatsa, Ministry of Healthcare in Samara region. The Department of Center and what are the results? Please answer this question before my conclusion. My conclusion will depend on your answers. Distinguished Gaidar Mamedovich, thank you very much for the question. In this case, the first question, when we speak about the comparison of the results of the laboratory activity, all the research which were obtained by us, they allowed us to be achieved on the basis of the model and multi fact approach we received and the ways of the increase of the quality of service availability, they broadly appeared in Samara region and mathematically calculated problematic zones when we see the zones of changes, but at the same time some starting points exist. The availability for remote regions, staff, personnel indicators, informatization, the third way offered by us. We see the results which are in the basis of our developed model. As for the hospitals where the implementations of our research were done, we were rescue teams for the healthcare organizers. We showed all the problems. This is the centralization, the focus within the frames of the medical institution, the staff, training of the staff, and so on, problematic informatization zones in the specific medical institutions. As for your third question, as for the organizational structure, it is very successful actual solution. In Moscow, there is a structure, organizational and methodological structure, which can help any specialist, outsourced specialist. It will help to understand all the trends. And when we see this opportunity on the level of Moscow, have a specific understanding that there are such opportunities and examples which must be realized in the region of Samara. Over 15 years, I'm a board member of National Institute of Simashka. You know that the candidate dissertation, it is the solution of a problem, a doctoral solution of a task, and doctoral thesis is a solution of a problem, and our candidate solved this problem. The conclusion, the thesis of Zolotarev Pavel Nikolaevich on the topic scientific rationale for multi-factor approach of laboratory service performance assessment in the Russian Federation constituent entity conforms with the main requirements of the order procedure on awarding degrees at St. Petersburg State University, and our candidate deserves the degree of the Doctor of Medical Sciences on specialization 140203, public health and healthcare service point 11, was not violated by our candidate. Thank you very much. Dmitry Petrovich, can you hear us and your review? Distinguished Igor Mikhailovich, distinguished board members, guests, as I am far away from St. Petersburg, let me read out my review, the thesis of Zolotarev. Nikolaevich submitted for the degree of the Doctor of Medical Sciences on specialty 140203, public health and healthcare service is actual and considerable significant work. On the background of other medical specialties, modern clinical laboratory diagnostics is not essential only at first sight. It only provides the activity of other medical directions. Nevertheless, on the clinical laboratory diagnostics, it is the background for other disciplines and the experience from foreign countries proves that laboratory service which is developing, it is concentrator and integrator of practically all clinical specialties, and some scientists connect with it even further progress of different spheres of medical science. As any medical sphere, clinical laboratory laboratory diagnostic can't stand still. It is constantly developing. For the first time, on the background of regulatory documentation in the sphere of laboratory service in the constituent entity of the Russian Federation, and the dissertation of Pavel Nikolaevich Zolotarev is the first in this problematics. It conforms with the specialty passport, public health and healthcare service. It is a new scientific direction and the scientific novelty. The main achievements of the author can be connected with the word for the first time because these results were obtained for the first time. The novelty of the research and the reliability of the research, the survey of the respondents was conducted, the timely proper analysis of the a new complex approach was conducted for the assessment of the activity of laboratory service, taking into account the necessity of doctors and satisfaction of the patients and so on. The questions of this satisfaction of the patients with laboratory service, the thesis is written in clear language. The structure includes introduction, literary sources for research chapters, conclusions, practical recommendations, the list of literary sources, and despite the all the advantages, this section could be shortened. I don't have principal remarks for the thesis. The thesis of Zolotarev Pavel Nikolaevich on the topic scientific rationale for multi-factor approach of laboratory service performance assessment in the Russian Federation constituent entity conforms with the main requirements stated from the 1st of September 2016, number 6821/1. Procedure on awarding academic degrees at St. Petersburg State University, and our candidate Pavel Zolotarev deserves the degree of the Doctor of Medical Sciences on specialization 14.02.03 Public Health and Healthcare Service. Point 11 of the order was not violated by the candidate. Do you have any comments upon it? I would like to thank Vladimir Petrovich for the remarks, and I would like to give the floor for Salimovich Bilalov. It is foreign expert, and we glad that Fanil, we are glad that Fanil Samyevich agreed to become the expert. In fact, I would like to agree. I agreed to take part in this meeting with great pleasure. If we over the last 10 years. Laboratory service has suffered a lot. The logical processes of centralization, implementation of devices in the wards, all these requires evaluation. The works which were defended or published, they were connected with the evaluation of the measures which were taken by regional healthcare bodies, the work which evaluates this event, and in fact, they were connected with a specific action in the region. And the fact that the Russian Federation is very vast territory and geographical peculiarities of our regions, they are specific. And if we take huge megapolises, here we can have specific conditions of laboratory research. And there are subjects of the Russian Federations. And the systems of the complex approach for the assessment of the laboratory services, they require a complex approach with the use of multi-factor approach. On the And a new model of the organization of not only laboratory service and our medical services on the whole, and the traditional model of the public form of the medicine is very solid. But today, the model of the organization of private medical services, when and they are implemented by the participants of the private models, and principally new model of private partnership. It is born in within the walls of the public health care service, and it requires complex approach and evaluation of estimation. And we heard that the work on the assessment, not only the current state by dynamics observation and reading the work, I was very glad that this work, its fundamental character, a very in-depth statistical method was used, and my colleagues marked these moments and the approach to the use of mathematical statistical methods. It allows us to define the trend which is observed in the service. It is the indicator for the acceptance of managerial solutions. The work is of fundamental character. All modern Western publications are closely connected with the analysis of big data. No voice in the microphone. the approach which is used by our candidate, the implementation of the system, it is the first step for the analysis of big data and the computer program itself. No voice in the microphone. With the help of the work of the researchers we heard today, and informational system which are developed, they will find their own way of the further development with the help of the integration of this data. The laboratory service, it is a broad section of our medicine. In laboratory diagnostic, a lot of methods are used. According to the recent data from the Federal Reference Book of Laboratory Researchers, more than 13,000 of different types of laboratory researchers, and this fundamental character of the work of Pavel Nikolaevich, it concerns the integration of the data with the aim of the evaluation managerial solution. As for the work itself, the work is in the form of dissertation and contains all necessary sections. And there are some inaccuracies which don't spoil the work itself. No voice in the microphone. And it is necessary to focus on the universal character of the work. A lot of questions have already been asked. I think that the thing that our candidate, the question concerned concerned conceptual framework of medical laboratory service. Medical laboratory service is different from medical services by the fact that not only medical worker takes part in the process, but also non-medical worker takes part in the process. Laboratory researches are delivered by couriers, drivers in the laboratory work, biologists and other specialists work. In conclusion, I want to say that the thesis of Pavel Nikolaevich Zolotarev, scientific rationale for multi-factor approach of laboratory service performance assessment in the Russian Federation constituent entity, is completed work. And methodology of the assessment of the activity of regional services, clinical laboratory diagnostic. The thesis conforms with the requirements stated by the order from the 1st of September 2016, number 6821/1, procedure on awarding degrees at St. Petersburg State University, and our candidate deserves the doctoral degree on specialization 140203, public health and healthcare service. Point 11 was not violated by the candidate. Fanil Salimovich, thank you very much for the remarks and all the proposals. No voice in the microphone. They are very important in the for the science and my review. I am not going to repeat everything. I was pleased by the members of our dissertation council. All these spheres of the layers of our today's healthcare service were covered, were mentioned. and I remember the piles of useless analysis before, for example, doctors say we don't have these or those things, it is necessary to buy them. The problem of technical equipment, it is a huge problem. Russia buys expensive equipment, and when I read this work, the language is perfect and fluent. It is very rare for the scientific work when the language is understandable and fluent. Methodology, it is very clear, and so on. I want to see another aspect. All sections are integral with any block, and we are in the process of digitalization today, for example. Apart, you see that our whole system of digitalization is not integrated on the whole. From which point should we start? And we will cut on the costs. And as a former minister, Gaidar Mamenovich understands that it is money. These are resources. We should understand today the number of the specialists which is necessary, and so on. The work conforms with the complex integral approach and interdisciplinary approach, a very difficult topic. It covers a lot of different specialists. It is the program in software itself, it is of complex and integral character. It is aimed at the whole region, and the final evaluation of the region is very important. 300 scores, Samara region. How many scores did Samara receive? Today, the subjects of the Russian Federation assessed according to integral indicator. All the aspects are distributed according to specific points. It is very interesting to receive those things. Topicality is without doubt the methodology which is implemented. There were questions. They were voiced on the whole. The work conforms with all the requirements and time for the degree of the Doctor of Medical Sciences. And without doubt, the work conforms with high requirements of St. Petersburg State University. Dear colleagues, that's all with the reviews of board members. Are there any volunteers, non-board members? 5 minutes for each volunteer. All those who entered himself into the list, please have the floor. Distinguished chairman, distinguished board members, colleagues, Pavel Nikolaevich, asking my question. First of all, having asked my question, I hoped that Pavel Nikolaevich will speak about the definition, existing definition, and in order to finish this thought, medical service is connected with laboratory, medical laboratory service, but I was delighted by his answer and detailed description of the situation where the doctor of primary contact, laboratory research, diagnosis, and final decision on the treatment of any patient. This know-how is the most significant in this research. And returning to the order 1804, there are more than 10,000 orders, and it's very difficult to understand anything there. And the proposal of Pavel Nikolaevich could play a crucial role for other specialties. According to the types of medical services and the types, there are about 27. And we know that medical services are very abstract if we speak about specific operations. For example, some operations are connected with gynecologists or other specialists, and it is my conclusion, and I would like to offer you something. Did you use these laboratory services, 300 services in your research, and how did you explain them with the help of the methods you mentioned? It is additional plus for your dissertation research. And if I were a board member, I would vote for the awarding of the degree. If we speak about the dynamics of laboratory research, we used 30th statistical form, where the least and huge cell, which allowed us to trace the changes of the number of the research in Samara region, and moreover, connected with the dynamics of the number of laboratory equipment which is used. We took into account its significance and logical resources of technological Pavel Nikolaevich, thank you very much. Are there any other volunteers? And you have the right to make general comments upon that. And now I would like to give the floor to scientific consultant, doctor of medical sciences, Cherkasov Sergei Nikolaevich. Distinguished chairman, distinguished board members, first of all, I would like to express my deep gratitude that we have to defend this thesis at St. Petersburg State University. And if we speak about the characteristics of our candidate, Pavel Nikolaevich, I have known Pavel Nikolaevich for a long time. I graduated from Samara Medical State University, and I knew him when he was a graduate student. He was a very hardworking student. He was very helpful, and then we did not communicate, but when Pavel Nikolaevich asked me to become his scientific consultant, I agreed. And I want to emphasize the fact that relationships of consultant and the candidate were very interesting. I was only the consultant. He deepened himself into the problem, and it allowed him to create a systematic work. And that's why all those characteristics he has and allowed him to be here today. On the one hand, he is a young person, and on the other hand, he is a mature person, a specialist. And from the point of view of personal characteristic, professional characteristic, he undertook classical weight. He became postgraduate student, defended candidate thesis. Then he was worked as an organizer of healthcare, clinical healthcare service. Then he worked in high school as an assistant associate professor. This is the classical way which helped him to be here today. Thank you very much, Sergei Nikolaevich. And now, dear colleagues, now it is a very serious moment, discussion of the work. And for the time, for some time, non-board members, please leave the hall. The broadcast is turned off. This is the procedure. threaten our assistance whether the broadcast is switched on. A very important moment is coming for the first time in our practice, on our specialty, an open voting in accordance with point 23, procedure for awarding academic degrees at St. Petersburg State University. I ask all the members of the thesis council. Olga Mironenko, are you foreign the guest? Distinguished Igor Mikhailovich, I support this work. Thank you very much. Dmitry Olegovich, your opinion? Distinguished Igor Mikhailovich. Alexander Leonidovich, your opinion? I am for. Dermamedovich, I am for. Dmitry Petrovich, your opinion? Hanil Salimovich, your opinion? I support it and I am for. Thus, as a result of open individual voting, all the board members, seven are for, no against, no abstain. Thus, the decision on awarding academic degree of the Doctor of Medical Science, specialization 14-0203, Public Health and Healthcare Service, is accepted to our candidate. Our congratulations and your final word. Distinguished board members, dear chairman, and dear guests, I would like to express my deep gratitude to everyone who helped me to prepare my thesis research. First of all, I would like to express my appreciation to the chairman of the thesis committee, Doctor of Medical Sciences Igor Mikhailovich Akulin, Director of St. Petersburg State University, Professor Nikolai Mikhailovich Kropachev, for this opportunity to have a thesis defense at this unique higher education institution. Secondly, I would like to express my sincere appreciation and gratitude to my scientific advisor, Doctor of Medical Sciences, Sergei Nikolaevich Cherkasov, who helped me at every single step of my thesis research. I would like to say, to express my gratitude to all the members of the thesis committee for their highly qualified and objective reviews, which helped me to put emphasis in the research and to look at the problems from a broader perspective, as well as for the overall positive assessment of the dissertation. I would like to thank Simashka National Research Institute of Public Health, represented by its director, Doctor of Medical Sciences Alexander Borisovich Zudin, the scientific supervisor of the institute, academician of the Russian Academy of Sciences, Professor Ramil Usmanovich Khabriev, and all the members of the institute for their attention to my scientific work. I would like to thank my family, which supported me. Thank you very much for your attention, please switch off the broadcast.